Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how I painted this splashing wave here. Yeah, after a quick color mixing process and preparing the board for this painting here, I start to apply the color of the sky. Just one color, as you can see. Put it on roughly, more or less, and then start to blend so that we have a very even painting surface. Then I start to add the color for the sea part here. And add some linseed oil to the color of the wave. And then I basically put in the shapes very roughly, the way they appear on the reference material. Really just rough the mid-tone value that we have on each of the parts of this painting here. Just establish a certain color. And as you can see, no detail at all, just the rough color, and that's it. Then mix the next layer of color and start to build up the painting here. Painting is dry already now. And then I grab this very ragged old brush and start to put in those very fine little dots. Basically splashes from the wave, very fine ones. It's a very convenient, a very quick way of building up this these details here. And then I go in and build up the details, as you can see. The water tends to flock together, build some round shapes, and this is what you definitely need to put in to make this thing look realistic. And this process takes a while because the larger spots are all put in with a brush here. And I also start to build up the volume already, as you can see here. Using darker and lighter tones just to give this whole thing a shape and a volume. And this works also the other way around, taking a darker color and putting it on over this lighter color that we have in the background here. It's a very easy way to build up lots of millions of small dots. Here I want to show you how you very easy get the effect of the splashing water. This basically looks at the beginning like the beginning of a cloud painting, but I'm just painting the tip of the water, more or less. Over this still wet background color here. And I blend. And so we achieve a very nice effect of this 3D looking water here. Very easy way of getting in volume and also in more layers of detail. And this whole thing works also the other way around, getting with a lighter color over the still wet greenish color here. But you have to be careful not to use too much color, otherwise you can't put this white color over this greenish color here. And so this is a very easy way of building up volume also in this darker part here. See me building up an extension. And the same bit blending, and it really starts to look like real water. And this part here, just repeat the process, looks flat until now. And then I just grab a small brush and put in some darker tones here. Basically water flying around. And this very much immediately gives the impression of water, of this volume that the water has here. And the same goes for this part here. Basically, yeah, emerging, letting the darker water emerge from the darker color we have here on this part. Also toying around a bit with the value, getting a bit lighter, putting it on roughly, and then blending it. So that we have this appearance of this very soft water. And this part in the front, yeah, really looks like a cloud painting. No, but the reference material really looked a bit like that. And yeah, basically a dry brush technique here. Also getting in the volume that we need for this thing looking realistic. And don't forget the pure titanium white spots that we have here. Reflections more or less. And here we connect the water of the wave with the water of the sea. Getting also darker, as you can see. And then I basically just build up the detail parts here. Fine parts of the white water. Also putting in some lighter tones, some highlights, working back and forth. Big advantage of working with the oil color I'm using here. And we're finished, nearly. Ah, that's the finished painting. So I bet you now would like to see more wave painting tutorials. I got here a lot more of them.